Hello everyone, today I want to talk to you about building a cleric, and recently I've been discussing it a lot on the subreddit with other players, and they all seem to have different opinions on how to do this, and I decided to make a video to make it clear why I think some things are better than the other ones, and what in my opinion is the best way to build different clerics, like Monk, Sado and others. So, but the first thing I want to say is that ordering actually matters, because some of the cleric spells are independent of the level you can pick them on. So for example, heal, it just does 10% of HP, and it means that throughout the entire game you'll be able to restore at least 50% of HP to any character, no matter what HP they have. And safety zone, the same, it blocks 10 attacks, and it means that it will still block 10 attacks no matter what level you are, like level 10 or level 500. And there are some skills that are better to be picked as early as possible, like Zybus on Krivis, because the damage of the spell is very significant in the early game. This ability like destroys bosses and such, so if you, let's say, go wherever Krivis, you pick Krivis on rank 5, and there is no reason to pick this ability anymore, because it won't do as much damage as it could on rank 2, because it has a static attack, it doesn't scale with anything, well, except your intelligence of course, but if you don't got intelligence, there is no reason to pick it. So considering that, I think that this class is very underrated in the community. And this class cleric, like when you pick it the second time or maybe even the third time, this class can be a late game class, like it can fill some of the later ranks in your build, because all these spells like Fate, Divine Might, Safety Zone, Heal, they're all level independent, so you can pick it whenever you want. Of course, you don't want to pick the protected zone when you, if you pick this class sometime later. Same with Q, maybe like once to get this curing effect. So, okay. Now that I said that, let's make a monk build. And monk is a melee character. It starts with rank 5, and you usually pick it twice, because there are some very good skills that you want to pick in monk. And actually, prior to rank 5, priest doesn't have any great melee combat capabilities, so there are two ways of you getting to monk. First way is where you would want to benefit as much as you can from everything that you pick prior to monk, and the second way is where you would want to go through the early ranks as fast as possible without considering using your spells later when you are a monk already. And so I think that transferring some of your utility over to your monk is kind of useful, but you can still do it the other way. So you can just pick whatever the most powerful on your level is and don't care about anything. It's still alright. When you get to monk, you basically get a new life, so you don't you can ignore your previous abilities. So The way I build monk is I go, no cleric of course, double priest, paladin, and then double monk. The reason why I do this is because you won't have anything to attack with as a priest, so you'll be auto-attacking a lot, and for that you want blessing, which adds a static damage to your attacks. So it says plus 31, and that means that whenever you attack, your attack will first be reduced by some formulas like enemy's defense or something, and then this number 31 will be just added on top of it, so you'll at least hit for 31. And the other reason why I go double priest is sacrament, because in combination with blessing, it gives you a lot of damage, actually really a lot. You start killing monsters if you pick it at rank 3, you start killing monsters as fast as barbarians do, so it makes you an incredible melee character that also have such utility as a heal, safety zone, and some other buffs. So what it does is it adds a second attack instance to your regular attack, so you make one attack and two numbers start to fly around instead of just one. And that second additional attack also benefits from blessing. So here it says it that the other attack will do 24 damage, and this effect will be affected by blessing as well, so it will be plus 50. So if you don't train any attributes, this will be 74 damage, plus 74 damage to your attacks, and also your main attack still benefits from blessing as well, so you get like the double effect of blessing plus this tiny amount of damage that's really not really significant. So I think these two abilities make you an ultimate melee character, and it's really very strong, extremely strong, so strong that I would even consider going double priest with melee stats like dex or con, just because you will be able to do a lot of damage with these two abilities. So okay, let's go for monk. So of course you pick heal here, and what you pick, the other things you pick doesn't really matter, maybe like this or just 5d protected zones, it doesn't really matter. These two skills are very useful for you. Like then you pick priest, you pick blessing right away, and all these skills I like to pick for just one. This one is I pick for one because with level it increases the damage or the SP it takes, and if you pick it, you usually want it for the 20 percentages of defense, so plus 20 percentages of physical defense for 20 mana is very cool. This one for one because with level it only increases the debuff it puts on monsters, so it will always give you the same dexterity, and it gives you it in percentages. So since we are going monk, this one is very useful on bosses because it will give you a lot of dexterity. Blessing is obvious, and resurrection just for some utility. And by the time you pick priest, you want to get as many levels of this attribute as possible, and hence naturally blessing goes up by 4 every level. Like you see, currently it's 19, next one is 23, it goes by 4 every time. And this attribute gives you plus 2, so 2 levels of this attribute is basically 1 level of blessing, and you can get them, you can get 50 of them, so that means you can technically get a level 30 blessing on priest 2 if you somehow manage to raise it to 50. The next time you pick cleric, you want to go into these two spells, obviously, and then go wherever you want. I like to go full and heal, and then you have 7 points that no matter how you will spend, you can just play around with skills if you want. It doesn't really matter. So yeah, this is the reason why you went to priest 2, to make yourself a very strong melee character. So very early on, rank 3 at like level 45, I think, or something like this. Yeah, rank 2 is like level 17, I guess, or 15, I don't remember even. So at level 45 you'll be doing insane damage, actually. Next one I like to pick is Paladin, because of Smite. Smite is a very strong ability. Despite of having a high mana cost, it has a lot of damage, really incredible amount of damage. And if you're going Dexterity, which is an obvious pick, stat pick for Monk, because he also benefits from this thing, this ability will crit by a lot. It does insane crits, actually. It has a 9-second cooldown, which is very cool, and it has 2 overheads, so you can use it twice before it goes to cooldown. And with addition to your already powerful auto-attacks, this ability is very cool. Those are 2, obviously. This turn on that, I didn't really test it so much. I think that it's too high on mana. If it was like 10 mana maybe, then it would be worth picking, because it actually kills monsters. These 2 are very nice utility, so this one is very useful in maps where there are a lot of mage mobs and they do a lot of damage, actually. And this one is useful if you just exping. You can not really turn it on too much, because, well, it doesn't give you too much, but there is nothing else good to pick. But there is a very good attribute here that increases your mana recovery. You can pick it 5 times. So yeah, these 2 are like a tiny addition to the utility you already have from your previous ranks. And I think this is nice, but the main reason you go Paladin is Smite, because Smite does as much damage as Monk's attack. Like, it's actually a rank 5 spell, but you can pick it at rank 4, which is very cool. Well, then you go double Monk, obviously, max out your double punch. It picks just these 2, I think. Just 2 1-inch finger over hand knife, because they serve the similar purpose, but hand knife or 1-inch punch does much more damage, and energy blast, because it's your ultimate ability. But these stat points on Monk are still to be tested by me. I think I'll go this way, like I said. So it doesn't really matter. The point of this build is to actually get to Monk, and it doesn't really matter what you'll pick here. Obviously there are better builds, but I still need to test some skills on these ranks. So yeah, Double Priest and Paladin. I think this is the best choice. The other way you can go is Cleric. Hill. And you can go double Grievous like this. Oak Cross is not very useful. I don't think anyone should pick it. It's not very cool. And the reason you can go double Grievous is for Divine Stigma. It's a debuff you put on a monster, and when you finish it, it gives you, like, as you see, 43 strength and int to you and your entire party, It's very cool, but it still does. It still gives you much less damage than the priest combo of Sacrament and Blessing. And Zybus is not only it goes up in levels, which is already very cool. It also gets this attribute that starts making this spell AoE. So at first rank, this spell you put a circle. Maybe you can see a video here. Yeah, you put this circle, and it has 10 instances of damage. Whenever a monster runs in, it starts hitting it, just one monster, and then like the second one comes in and it starts hitting it a lot until it does all its 10 instances of damage. But when you pick this attribute, it becomes like that. You put a circle on the ground, and let's say there are three monsters standing, and they each get 10 instances of damage. So it's very powerful. It's probably insanely powerful, but it's also quite limiting, I think, because this spell is static. You can't move it around, and well, it's very good on AoE exping, but if you exp solo and you go like from one monster to another, you don't really make big packs of monsters. I think this spell is not very cool. And Zalkia, I guess, I don't know how to read it. It just gives you additional crit damage, which is also very cool because you won't go dex for monk, because abilities can crit too, and you'll be an ability-based character. And this one gives you crit damage that will sustain, that will anyway, it will help you. Like, you don't really want to go strength just for critical damage because you'll have Zalkia. Then after two Crisis, it's really questionable what to pick. Third Crisis is not very useful unless you want 10 Divine Stigmas, which is 78. But I don't think three triple Crisis is able to exp easily on rank 4. Rank 4 is quite tough. Maybe you'll go Paladin, and this will somehow boost your physical abilities. But that's the reason why I don't like this build, because you kind of go like into AoE and Divine Stigma, and your auto-attacking abilities are not very great, even though you have Stigma. And if you pick Paladin, it means that you'll be auto-attacking more. Well, I don't know. Maybe Paladin is the best pick here. Picking one priest is useless because it's just blessing, and it's already rank 4. It doesn't add really much. Picking cleric is maybe reasonable, but I don't think how. I don't think you can benefit from it as a monk. Bakura, it requires. Well, I didn't test it, but Effigy seems like a very strong ability, like insanely strong ability, but I don't really know. Picking just once means that you will neither go full support, because you need to pick dive twice for full effect, because you get owl here for damage, you get this thing, and these two things very high, so you can maintain them both at the same time without one of them going down. So picking just one dive is kind of useless, I guess. So I think Paladin, and then you go double monk. Yeah, double Grievous, Paladin, double monk. I think the double priest way is much better, just because it boosts you much more than double Grievous. So yeah, that's the monk builds, and about full support or kinda hybrid builds, I would still go double priest, then maybe paladin, just because of these two buffs. Resist elements is a very strong buff, extremely strong buff, stronger than anything any of these classes can give you at rank 4. But cleric is also an option. So double priest, cleric, you pick the other cleric, not because of heal, but because of safety zone. Safety zone is crazy. Divine Mind is also quite strong if your party consists of mages and maybe archers, I don't know. But they are mostly mages. Third priest is not very cool. Exorcise is a very weak ability, and this one only adds blocks, and if you go for party you don't really want your damage dealers to get hit. You obviously get the tank hit there, so this one is not really great as well. And a trunk for getting just some additional blessing and sacrament is not very cool as well, so I think paladin is a pick. And then I think you need to go double dive. Just if you go for party supporting, if you go like for duo supporting or something, you can just keep picking paladin like crazy, because the thing will just destroy everything. The damage from smite will be much better supporting than anything else you can pick. If you go for like for this sellout Padona, I think you can pick Krivis and then double Padona, because you'll be able to sell some more useful stuff. So I would go like paladin and double dive. I don't pick Oracle and Druid because I don't think they are particularly useful. Druid is cool, it has a very strong ability and it has some utility, but then you don't want to pick paladin. You can just go double dive and Druid if you want Druid. There's, well, several different ways to do this. And for full support priest, I would go for stats for spirit, con, and dex, I think. Yeah, spirit, con, dex. Hybrid support build, like for duo exping and such, where you actually want to do damage, I would go paladin, obviously. Then paladin again, and then maybe druid or oracle. Third paladin is not very cool. Barrier it might be cool, I didn't test it, I don't know how it works exactly. And this one seems a bit costly. So yeah, hybrid support build will go like this. Just like monk, but instead of monk you pick something else on rank 5 and 6. What else? Oh yeah, intelligence builds. If you go full intelligence, it probably cool to pick cure as well. I don't really know. I still don't like this ability. But anyway, if you go full intelligence, your best choice is Krivis because of Zybos. And this doesn't matter which ones you'll take. You want to take this one not because of critical hit, but because of magic amplification. Magic amplification adds flat damage to your magic damage. So you can pick it 4 times. It means that you can get plus 48, and it works like blessing, but for your magical attack. So this does like 10 hits, 9 hits. And this adds 48 to each of the hits, so it like makes your Zybos a little higher level. So yeah, Krivis is definitely the choice here. Next you can go Bakor, just because these two abilities are extremely strong. But you can also go Krivis. I think Krivis is better, just because Zybus gets splash and equipping some utility like this. Then you obviously go Sado. Sado is the best intelligence, is the best damage you can get with your intelligence build. And I think possession is quite strong. I don't think this thing is strong, maybe for PvP, or I don't really know where this is in the game even. You need to channel it and it decreases the stats of enemies. So yeah, you go double Sado, at least double Sado. Third Sado, you can go for it just for damage, and transmit prana is not very cool, I think. You can also go druid here because you have more damage. And yeah, I don't think there are choices. So yeah, for intelligence based build, you want to go double Krivis, just because Zybus gets splash and Zybus in is incredibly strong spell. Yeah, I think that's it. That's how I see monk builds, at least. And for stats, for monk, you want to go like 75 dex and 25 con, I would say. For full support, I would go 60 dex, 20 spirit, 20 con. For hybrid support build, I would go 75 dex, 25 con. I think maybe I'll take spirit, I don't really know, but very unlikely. For full end build, I will go 100 to end. Oh yeah, I forgot. If you go Sado, there is another way of doing this. It's by boosting safety zone. You boost safety zone as much as you can, and you also get fate, and then you go double Sado. That's if you play solo. I think if I was playing solo, I would go at least double cleric. Not sure about the third cleric. Maybe I would go Krivis and then cleric. But you really need safety zone and fate for your Sado if you want to play solo, because when you go get out of your body, you play as your spirit and your body remains unprotected, and your monsters start going towards your body, and whenever you get hit, this ability interrupts and goes to a 9 second cooldown. So if you play solo, I think you want to put safety zone here, and this way you'll get 20 seconds of kinda immunity. And when it inspires, you can also go fade, which is another 20 second, which will like get you to the safety zone and it cooldowns. So yeah, if you play solo, I would go cleric, maybe Krivis, I'm not sure about this. But I'll pick cleric at least twice before Sado. So yeah, that's it for the builds, I guess. Thanks for watching.